¿Cuánto consideras que es un buen sueldo en México?
Yo personalmente la armaría con unos...
How much can you earn in Mexico? Is Mexico a good place to make your fortune? What kind of salaries and benefits do Mexican people enjoy? If you've seen my channel, you'll know that a lot of people from all over the world are coming to live here. Maybe you are one of them. As well as our amazing food, weather, traditions, culture, history, I could go on. One of the main reasons that people mention when they talk about why they want to live here is the low cost of living. As a Mexican, this always surprises me. Mexico doesn't seem that cheap to me. Perhaps their country is just expensive. In this video, I'm going to show you what it's like to work in Mexico and what is considered a good salary here. I'm going to be talking to people to ask them their opinion about what is a good salary here. Stick around because I'll also mention a few other things about working in Mexico which will come as a surprise to a lot of foreigners. Maybe you'll have a totally different opinion about working in Mexico after watching this video.
¿Cuál es el sueldo, un buen sueldo aquí en México para ti en general?
Para vivir mensualmente, algunos 30 mil pesos mensual.
¿Qué tipo de trabajos te ofrecen este tipo de sueldo? ¿Existente?
La iniciativa privada, pero puestos gerenciales para arriba.
¿Cuál sería el estilo de vida de una persona que tiene ese sueldo?
Es un estilo de vida de media alta, donde puedes vivir bien y adquirir con ahorrando. Y pues un poco de esfuerzo, algunas cosas.
¿Como viajar?
Sí, viajar, comer en un restaurante, pasear, no sé, tener un coche, un carro, echarle gasolina a tu carro, vestir.
¿Cuánto creen ustedes que sería un buen salario para vivir cómodo aquí en México?
Pues de 150 a 200 pesos diarios.
¿Y usted igual?
Con todas las prestaciones de ley.
10 mil a 12 mil pesos al mes.
2.500 a la quincena, a la semana, perdón.
¿Qué tipo de trabajo puedes obtener con ese salario?
Un guardia de seguridad.
¿Qué?
Porque estoy trabajando.
¿Y estudias también?
Estudio.
Pues ahora sí que en fábricas y dependiendo de cómo sea, de cuál sea tu experiencia.
¿Qué puedes conseguir con ese salario?
No sé, podría decir una buena renta, comida, algunos mueblecitos que te hagan falta.
Bueno, aquí en Querétaro me alcanzaría para la renta, los pagos de agua, luz, internet, mi colegiatura de escuela, comida para la quincena.
I'm also going to tell you about my experience working here in Mexico, but you'll have to wait until a little bit later on.
Yo creo que yo personalmente la armaría con unos 15 mil mensuales, digo, quincenales.
¿Cuál sería un estilo de vida bueno
que me permitiría
con ese dinero?
Yo creo que la renta de un departamento, tal vez, comida para mí, en este caso, que no tengo nadie más, mis mascotas y todos los servicios básicos, y obviamente pues también unos gustitos, ¿no? Salir a comer o a pasear o comida.
¿Qué tipo de trabajo podría darte esos 15 mil quincenales o 30 mil mensuales?
Yo creo que ser gerente de alguna empresa que esté bien posicionada.
¿Crees que es fácil en México conseguir eso?
No, definitivamente no. Yo creo que ya ahorita ni siquiera con una maestría la armas tan fácil. Tienes que seguir estudiando mucho o de plano tener un buen contacto por ahí.
Como 20 mil. Por ejemplo, yo soy edecán. Entonces, sí, más o menos puedes dar un sueldo de esa cifra.
Si puedes ser un ingeniero y puedes ganar 15 mil, pero puedes ser obrero y puedes ganar 4 mil. Así que está muy pobre tener un título.
¿Qué te alcanza? ¿Qué puedes comprar con esos 15 mil al mes?
Tienes un trabajo que te da 15 mil, puedes comprarte lo que quieras, pero alguien que tiene gastos como la renta, el carro, los hijos, no te alcanza para nada esos 15 mil.
Unos 12 mil al mes, yo digo que estarían bien.
I know that these interviews aren't scientific. These are just a few people who were around the center of Querétaro on a Wednesday afternoon and who were kind enough to participate. This isn't a very representative sample of Mexicans if we are talking about the whole country, but it's interesting to hear people's opinions. Let's remember that we are in Querétaro.
the state with the third highest salaries in the country. It's no wonder that so many people want to live here. Unlike in other parts of the world, the minimum wage in Mexico is calculated per day rather than per hour. At the moment, this is 141.7 pesos in most of the country, which is equivalent to $7.06 a day. In the north of the country, in the states which border the US, the salaries are a little bit higher, at 213 pesos or $10.60 a day. And now you might be thinking, how many people are earning that much? And that's a very good question. Around 13.4 million people, or just over 10% of the population, is listed as earning the minimum wage or less. In fact, 60.7% of Mexicans are registered as earning less than 2 times the minimum wage, the equivalent of $370 a month. If you're in Mexico and you make over 38,000 pesos a month, or $1,900, you belong to the richest 1% of the country. Now, one thing that is worth mentioning is that a large percentage of people in Mexico work in the informal sector. With over half of the workforce working in the informal economy, as well as some people who may not be declaring all of their income, I don't know how reliable these official figures are. All those people might be making savings on their tax bill, but they're also missing out on a lot of benefits that we Mexicans enjoy when we are employed. Now, every legally employed worker in Mexico is entitled to certain benefits. This might not sound like the most interesting topic, but it's important to take into account when talking about salaries in Mexico, because these benefits can really add up. I'm really curious to hear what people from other countries think about this. Do you have something similar where you are? If not, would you like to have something like this? You must be registered in IMSS, the Mexican Social Security System. If you're a public servant, there's another service with slightly different benefits. This gives you the following: free healthcare in IMSS hospitals, a state pension, nursery for your kids, and social centers such as theaters, gyms, etc. This is part of IMSS, but it's worth mentioning separately. Each month that you work, your employer has to pay an additional 5% of your salary into a housing fund. As your housing fund builds up, you earn points. Once you have enough points, you're entitled to a mortgage from the government, and you can use your housing fund as a down payment. Once you have the mortgage, your payments are taken directly from your salary, and your employer keeps paying the 5%. Not bad. In your first year of work, you aren't entitled to any vacation, apart from national holidays. After 1 year, you get 6 days paid vacation. After that, you get 2 extra days per year worked for 5 years. And then it keeps increasing, but more slowly. When a baby is born, the mother gets 12 weeks off and the father 5 days. Everyone gets at least 2 weeks' salary as a Christmas bonus. If you get married, you get 3 days paid vacation and a month's salary at a minimum wage, which is around 4,000 pesos. Every private company is legally required to share 10% of its profits with its workers every year. A lot of companies find a way around this, but I've got friends who've received a very good amount of money. After listening to those people, it actually sounds very accurate. I remember I got my first job and I was earning $350 a month. It was my first job and that was a salary for a person who didn't have any experience, but I was working in Mexico City, one of the most expensive cities in Mexico. That didn't seem like a good salary to me at that time because I remember I was living in a dangerous area and I was sharing the room and I could barely pay my services and a need, of course. After having worked for a year, I finally got another job where they were paying me 16,000 pesos a month before tax. And at that time, I felt a huge difference. I was finally living in another area in Mexico City. It wasn't dangerous. Actually, it was nice. Of course, I shared my apartment, but I was able to travel inside Mexico. Actually, I traveled outside Mexico, and I was able to do that because the company was offering benefits. And those benefits were a big help. Then I came to Querétaro and I set up a business with a friend. It didn't work, so I started to look for a job and I found an international company. I felt very lucky because they offered me 17,000 pesos a month before taxes. And I felt like I was having a decent lifestyle again. And remember, this was with a degree and 3 years of experience. I felt this was a very comfortable salary for me. I remember I could do everything I wanted without feeling that I needed more. But let's remember that I also had the benefits given by law. And not only that, they also gave me additional benefits that are quite normal for professional jobs. For example, they gave me a card, like a debit card that I can use only at the supermarket. You can use this to buy basic products like food and all the basics. No beer. In my case, they gave me 1,500 pesos a month, which was good, not bad. For free, Fondo de Ahorro, which means savings fund. Every month, the employer takes a percentage of your salary and puts it into a fund. But not only that, the employer matches the same amount of money, and at the end of the year, the employer gives it to you all in one go. In my case, it was 12% of my salary. 12% extra for free was good. Remember that everybody has 2 weeks of salary as a Christmas bonus given by law. Well, in my case, I had a month, double. I'm telling you this because all the benefits I got made my compensation considerably more than the salary itself sounds. My husband, who's a foreigner, was also working here in a company in Mexico. Let's ask him his experience. Come here. So tell me, Dave, what sort of job did you have?
I worked in English schools, in different kinds, like private schools and language centers and things like that.
So tell me, does a foreigner earn more money in Mexico?
Some do, I think, but English teachers probably not. I think English, what I was earning was quite normal for a Mexican salary. For somebody with a degree. At one school, I made a video about this a long time ago, so you can watch watch it from the start.
I'm going to put the link here.
Yeah, so it's all there. But at one job, I was making 14,000 pesos after tax a month. Mm-hmm. Another, I earned 19,000 pesos before tax, which was about 16,500 after tax. Mm-hmm. I didn't get all of your benefits.
Why?
I don't know, because they didn't like me as much. But I did get a lot more holidays because there was a teacher. Mm-hmm. And another job that I did, I was getting paid per hour, and they paid me 150 pesos an hour.
That's good. Because in Mexico, nobody pays you per hour in a company. In a,
That's weird.
It seems in your case, you didn't have any preference, let's say, for being a foreigner.
Maybe not, no.
And I don't think that happens here in Mexico.
Maybe, well, but not in my case.
We don't know. Just to clarify, you were working here in Querétaro.
Yes.
So, thank you. Okay, so guys, what do you think about the salaries in Mexico? Please let me know in the comments what's an average salary in your country. And if you're from a different part of Mexico, what do you think of the salaries that people mentioned? Is it more or less the same, an average? Let me know in the comments as well. As I already mentioned, I started making this channel when I was working before going to Vietnam. And I remember I made a video about cost of living here in Querétaro. I'm gonna leave the link here so you can watch it. When we came back from Vietnam, I made another video about our monthly expenses. And I was shocked that we were spending more money. And I felt very guilty, I must say. I wasn't sure about making that video. I'm gonna leave the link here if you want to watch it. But what surprised me is that I was receiving a lot of comments from people from other countries saying that that was very cheap. I even remember someone told me that I was lying. It's funny because I was thinking, am I showing off? But it's all about perspectives, I think. If you've seen my channel before, you'll know that I make videos trying to show Mexico from the point of view of a Mexican. I hope this video has done that and you found it interesting. I often see foreigners on Facebook or YouTube saying that Mexico is really cheap. And I think it's great that you can have a better standard of living here compared to in your country. But it doesn't necessarily seem cheap for a lot of Mexican people. As you've seen, you can live very well on a Mexican salary. But if you're talking on social media and saying how cheap everything is, just remember that Mexican people are watching too. And well, what do you think about this video? Tell me in the comments. I am very open to hear every kind of comments. If you like this video, I've got more videos like this on my channel, so check them out. And see you in the next video. Adios.